The Supreme Court has given a week's time to Delhi, Uttar Pradesh and Haryana to decide on a consistent policy for interstate movement in Delhi and the National Capital Region. Delhi sealed its borders for a week on Monday amid a continuous rise in coronavirus cases. The same day, Haryana lifted a seal at the Gurgaon border but reimposed it. Noida and Ghaziabad, meanwhile, have also restricted movement to Delhi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and his Australian counterpart, Prime Minister Scott Morrison, took part in the first ever virtual bilateral summit. The event signifies the strengthening of ties with Australia and its upward trajectory, the MEA stated in a release on Wednesday. The virtual summit was held as Prime Minister Morrison's visit to India could not take place amid the COVID-19 pandemic. Two MLAs, Akshay Patel and Jitu Bhai Chaudhary, both from the Congress, have resigned from the post of MLA. Rajendra Trivedi, the Gujarat Assembly Speaker, said he accepted their resignations. The Congress had suffered a jolt in March when five of its MLAs had resigned, bringing down its tally to 68. The latest developments have left the Congress dismayed ahead of the elections to four Rajya Sabha seats. Industrialist and Managing Director of Bajaj Auto, Rajiv Bajaj, called the COVID-19 lockdown draconian during a conversation with Congress leader Rahul Gandhi. He said such a situation was not even called for during the World War. Bajaj, a longtime critic of the government, said that the lockdown decimated the economy and exposed us to the worst of both worlds. On Wednesday, Delhi reported more cases of novel coronavirus infections than Mumbai, the first time such a thing has happened in more than 2 months. Delhi discovered 1,513 new cases, its highest single-day figure, while Mumbai, which is the city with the maximum number of cases, found 1,276. Meanwhile, Delhi has ordered a mandatory 7-day home quarantine for people arriving in the capital via flight, bus or train, tweaking its earlier rule. The World Health Organization has decided to resume the hydroxychloroquine trials in an effort to find a treatment for COVID-19. This the body did after halting trials when The Lancet issued an expression of concern over a study it had published that had questioned the effectiveness of HCQ. The WHO Director General Tedros Ghebreyesus said that on the basis of the available mortality data, there are no reasons to modify the trial protocol, thus giving the green flag for the resumption of the trials. Union Minister for Environment Prakash Javadekar tweeted that the government has taken very serious note of the elephant's killing in Kerala. He wrote, "We will not leave any stone unturned to investigate and nab the culprits. This is not Indian culture to feed firecrackers and kill." There has been an outpouring of outrage at the killing of a wild elephant in Kerala. A high-level team has been formed to investigate it.